Oh, we make it very short.
Okay, I will take over from there.
Yeah, that was easy.
Like Claudio said, Pearl Heffron. This is the fifth year in a row that Pearl is at Vosden, both with a Heffron and a booth. And you know, maybe I've seen the booth already. It's downstairs, something like 20 meters from here, I think, 30 meters. And we have got there the largest library of Pearl books in the world. You can look at the books, not take them, not buy them for me, because some of them are unique by now. I do have books for sale, books from O'Reilly, Pearl books of course, books from No Starts, like the newest one, Pearl One Liners. I've got The Beginning Pearl by Curtis Poe. I've got these lovely little camels for sale for a mere 15 euros. They're cute. I've got mugs. And we've got buttons, stickers. Stickers, zelfen. We've got stickers, like you requested. Brochures and other stuff. You're very welcome to come by and see what we have. I hope that our list of speakers will please you. And at the end of the day, there will be a one-hour talk by Jonathan Worthington about all the things that are possible with Pearl 6. So it's not about we are going to do this and we have done that, but this you can do now. Okay. To show you that Pearl 6 is something that you can use already.
That's not good.
You're rotating as well?
Yeah,
yes. At the booth, I've got a brochure about dinner tonight. I deserve dinner at La Porteuse d'Eau, which means the bearer, the lady bearer of water. It's a magnificent, lovely restaurant. We are on the, not the ground floor, but the first floor. The price of the meal is something like 20 or 25 euros per person. Excluding drinks, you have to pay for yourself. There's a maximum of 50 people at the moment. I've got 26 places fixed, taken. So 24 people more can join us. Come to me, tell me your name, I will put you on the list, and you will be fine. And on the paper that I have, there's the address and stuff, but you have to be on what time you have to be there. The same for tomorrow. Tomorrow night I have reserved a nice restaurant, a Lebanese restaurant. The restaurant tonight is typically Belgian. We ate excellent food. We have been eating there last year and we were so happy that we come there again. Tomorrow will be a Lebanese restaurant. The prices will be a bit cheaper and I've reserved for at least 15 people. At the moment I've got seven places filled. And they are normally closed on a Sunday evening. But when we come with at least 15 people, they will open. So if you want to go to the Lebanese restaurant, which is the best Lebanese restaurant of Brussels, come to me, tell your name, and I will put you on the list. Is there anything more to say? Well, enjoy the butterfly. We picked it up today. Yesterday. We picked it up yesterday. It's a completely new thing for Pearl to have something like that. I never seen something like that for Pearl, so we are very proud to have that.
And you can tell where the Pearl thing comes from.
Ah, yes.
Did you nick that from some town?
I will put that here for the moment. This is, or was, whatever, the sign for the train station of the city of Pearl. Yes. year and a half ago, we had the Pearl Reunification Summit in the city of Pearl, where we tried to reunite Pearl 5 and Pearl 6, and in some ways we succeeded. It would have been a bit better to make it possible to run Pearl 6 and Pearl 5 and Pearl 5 and Pearl 6 and to make people work together. So we had something like 30 famous Pearl people together. Larry Wall was there, for instance, and many, many other famous people. We've been there for 3 days, and on the second day, we were going to Bohr. So, little explanation, Pearl is a city in Germany, on the three country points of Germany, Luxembourg and France. Well, you know, Pearl, the language of freedom, you can do everything with it. they do it for the long way. So on the Luxembourg side, there is Schengen, the city of European freedom. And on the French side, there's Apache. I'm not making it up, it's really the case, Apache. So anyway, we are going to Bourg, which is one of the villages of the city of Bourg. And on our way there, we would pass the train station. And Liz and I knew there was this wonderful terrace with this hanging up under it. So we was going to make a group picture underneath this thing. So there we were, like, the roof is gone. They're tearing down the building. The roof is gone. Where is the sign? Shit. Everybody searched. So they searched and they, yeah, here it is. Okay, so fine. So we held it ourselves up, like, above our heads. So the group picture is quite nice. And we put it back. Later that night, Liz, my partner, had to pick up somebody from the train station, a latecomer. And this thing was still standing on the same place. And Liz yelled, if there is somebody who says that I cannot take the sign, stick up now, otherwise I will take it. Nobody said anything.
You didn't make it through with yours.
So now we have the sign. We've spoken to several people of the town of Pearl, and they are very happy that we, as the Pearl community, have the sign of Pearl because we deserve it, and nobody in the city of Pearl would mind, and they are all happy with us. So, there you have it.
Keep talking.
Why did we go to the city of Bourg? You know, Bourg from the Sessions is futile. From Star Trek, some of you might have seen Star Trek. They have excavated a Roman villa there. So in Pearl there's a Roman villa called
something
do?
Like. We're going to film it a little farther away, so we have the screen and yourself in the same image, instead of apart.
It's 2 square kilometers big. It's a building with a wall around it, and slave quarters, and staff quarters, and whatever. And they're excavating piece by piece, and they have reconstructed the villa. And they have found drawings of it, of the villa. You want to say something?
I just want to ask a question.
Yes?
Could you say shortly something about the schedule today? It's better than Bourg.
Bourg, okay. So I'm done about the... I was done about Bourg. And the schedule today is as it is on in the booklet, except for one thing, maybe. At 12 o'clock, Paul Leonard Evans would give a talk about asynchronous programming. This morning, very early, he gave me a text message like, I'm sick, probably food poisoning, my food is going everywhere except for the right place. So if you have somebody that can replace me, please. So I have asked Riba Sushi, and he said yes, and he will be here at 12 o'clock. So if Paul is not here to give a talk about asynchronous programming, Riba Sushi will give a talk, and I think it will be out about DBAX class, so I think that might be interesting as well. I have seen an earlier version of that talk, it was a little bit above my head, a little bit difficult for me, but I think you will enjoy it. And for the rest, the schedule is okay. Any more questions about today? No? I think we should start then, at some point. Are you ready?
Yeah, I don't think they managed to get technology working, but...
We don't get your slides, but I will record you with slides.
The camera's working?
Sorry?
The camera's working?
Yes, that's fine.
Hello?
Yes,
you so are. So they've got my criminal story about the coral?
Yes, we have that.
Okay.
We can see you on YouTube soon enough.
Yeah.
And now they will end. Where is our coral slide?
No, they don't.
Oh.
And another butterfly. Yes? Marcus, take it away.
Alright. Hello, gang. I am Marcus Ramberg, and you might know me from projects like Catalyst and Moulicious, but today I'm here to talk about Convos, a modern IRC client for your browser. I run an Oslo-based company called Nordocker, where we do both consulting and product development. In addition to Canvas, this fall we launched two new products.